هذا الدجال لعنة الله عليه وعلى كل الدجالين والخونة في العالم.
انتصر، فانتصر رسول الله، قال انتصرت بأهل بيتي. عندنا أحمد ديدات كان في جنوب أفريقيا، هذا الداعية الإسلامي المعروف، وسبب توجه أحمد ديدات إلى أنه يرفع صوت الإسلام ويقف بوجه النصارى وأهل الكتاب في العالم، سببه كتاب الرحلة المدرسية للشيخ محمد جواد البلاغ النجفي. هو أحمد ديدات ذاكر هذا في مقابلة في إحدى المجلات، يقول أنا في جنوب أفريقيا ولد شاب كنت، فجالس في دكان عمي عنده دكان بقالة، ويأتونه بدفاتر يبيع سكر شاي تتن تبيض كذا، فيلف السكر والشاي بأوراق من هذه الكتب. يقول فنظرت إلى كتاب اسمه الرحلة المدرسية قبل أن يصل إلى يد عمي ويمزق ورقة ويبيع على الناس. يقول أنا أخذت هذا الكتاب وبدأت أقرأه، وإذا هذا الكتاب غير أحمد ديدات وحول إلى داعية إسلامي كبير. طيب،
well, to confess, I myself, I don't know Arabic. I'm telling you honestly.
The only thing I knew about Islam was that I was a Muslim and I read the Shahada. We call it the Kalima, the Shahada. And if I met you around that time, I would have asked you where you come from. So you come from the UAE. Says, what are you? Suggesting to you, are you a Muslim or what? So you say, no, I'm a Muslim. Says, read the Shahada. And if you could read the Shahada, if you said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, you pass. To me, you are a Muslim. If you can't say that, you are not a Muslim. If you can utter that, you are a Muslim. What it meant, I didn't know. It was like a magic formula. If one can say it, he becomes a Muslim. If he can't say it, he's not a Muslim. That's all. That's my knowledge of Islam. I prayed the way my father prayed. I fasted the way he fasted. And I knew that we Muslims don't eat pig, we don't drink alcohol, we don't gamble, we don't dance, and things like that. That was my knowledge of Islam. But these people are making life miserable for me. And there was no way out. Either I leave the job and run away, or fight back. But one cannot fight back without knowledge. But Allah is Musabbibul Asbab. He is the creator of opportunities. He had created in me a hunger for reading. See, maybe because of that loneliness, me and my father, what could we talk? The only two. You go and eat in a hotel and come and sleep in an apartment, sharing the quarters with other people. What can we talk? Nothing. So somehow I had developed a hunger for reading. I just must read anything, everything. Go to the library, read all the magazines, read all the books. And at one time, it was hard for me to find a book which I hadn't read. So I had to keep on going through them. Saying, this I wrote, finished. This already I had read. This I had. It was hard for me to find a book in the library which I hadn't browsed through. So this was the hunger that I had. And this hunger of mine led me to find a book called Izharul Haq. And this book changed my life. So now it carried on. If there's a debating society, I would join. I would debate. Anything with friends, arguing, debating. And then until I was thrown into the lion's mouth, so to say, at this Christian mission place. And now the Christian missionary, they are challenging me. And now I get the weapon. Allah Bari Ta'ala supplied me with an armor. How to defend myself. This book I spoke about, Izharul Haq, was written by Sheikh Rahmatullah.
A natural urge for reading. And one Sunday morning, going into my boss's warehouse, go down, I was rummaging through a pile of old newspapers, looking for some better reading material than newspapers to read. And as I was looking for such a material, I came across a worm-eaten book. This book, we have renewed the cover, but a worm-eaten book. And when I picked it up, I started to sneeze because it was all full of mildew. And I read the title of the book. It said, Izharul Haq, spelled out in Latin script, Izharul Haq. Izharul Haq. Now, to me, that sounded Arabic, Izharul Haq. It sounds like Arabic. So I didn't know what it meant. I see here at the bottom it says The Truth Revealed. This was a very old publication, printed in 1915 in India. 2 years older than myself. I was born in 18. This is 3 years older than myself. Now, this book actually changed my life.